Hyperinsulinism is a congenital disorder of regulation of insulin secretion.
The cells in the pancreas that make insulin can't turn that insulin off, and when that happens, the blood sugar becomes dangerously low.
Basically, it's the opposite to diabetes. Children that have hyperinsulinism produce too much insulin, and that causes severe low blood glucose.
Blood sugar feeds the brain, and it's what our body uses for energy as a whole.
So when you feel low blood sugar, you may feel weak, you may feel confused and disoriented, or you may have seizures.
And so that puts the brain at higher risk for suffering damage.
That's why it's so important to detect when infants have a low level of blood sugar to be able to correct it as soon as possible.
The longer it takes until diagnosis and referral, the higher likelihood that the child will have catastrophic consequences, including severe brain injury.
At the Children's Hospital of Philadelphia Hyperinsulinism Center, we see approximately two-thirds of all the cases that are born in this country with hyperinsulinism.
Once the diagnosis of hyperinsulinism is made, we need to educate the family as to what is hyperinsulinism, what can be causing the hyperinsulinism, and how can we treat the hyperinsulinism.
There are two types of hyperinsulinism. There is a diffuse form and there is a focal form.
When there's diffuse disease, all of the insulin secreting cells in the pancreas are abnormal. But when it's focal disease, a very small cluster of cells measuring perhaps less than a quarter of an inch in diameter are abnormal.
So focal form really means that just part of the pancreas is affected, and once that part that's affected is taken out, it's curable, the disease is curable. For diffuse, typically the whole pancreas is affected, all the beta cells are not functioning properly, and the babies need a near total pancreatectomy, or 95 to 98% of their pancreas removed.
By doing genetic screening and finding out what gene is defective in these children, we can very, with high accuracy, determine who has focal hyperinsulinism and who would have diffuse hyperinsulinism.
When we start thinking about medical management versus surgical management, the genetics play an important role.